My name is Doug Ferguson, and I teach fifth grade here at Martin Sortun, and I'm also in charge of our robotics program. We use Lego Mindstorms kits, and that really, it helps students who are struggling a little bit with math and science, and helps empower them to know that, one, they can do math and science, but two, it can be fun, and three, actually, they can do some pretty advanced stuff.
I like our robotics because it helps us learn about the sound weights, and it's good because we learn how to measure.
Basically, they are running the robots, but they're also running the sensors while they run the robots and logging in the data for that and then uploading that into the computer and being able to analyze those graphs. One's working with our sound sensors, and they currently are monitoring the sound in the room and kind of looking at the ebb and flow of the conversation. The other group's looking at reflectivity of light, and they're looking at different colors of construction paper and how different colors on the light spectrum reflect different amounts of light. The final group in the back corner there, that's our first robotics team. And they're currently running their competition robot, which is going through a series of challenges that are designed to simulate responses to natural disasters.
So we're gonna move the robot, move the ambulance to the safe zone so we can get points at the tournament. And if we get it back, if we get into the blue or yellow, if we get into blue, that's really good.
Basically get the kids that hands-on experience so that students can really look into the material at a deeper level than they would otherwise. We're really focused on the whole package too. We're really looking at STEM, which is that science, technology, engineering, and math. And that takes several forms here. The science piece is a rich piece. We can do data logging experiments where the kids can really take the sensors and do some in-depth analysis. And the students do a rotation where every student in the fifth grade here at Martin Sortun comes through and gets that hands-on time with the robots for science. We're looking at the technology piece, some of the more subtle aspects, include the programming that the students have to learn to be able to run the robots, and just preparing them in many ways for the future in technology. The engineering piece is probably the most overlooked piece of STEM. The robots really hit that piece well as far as the design is concerned for the students. And the last piece is math, and there's a lot of math involved with these robots. The kids are really having to look at decimals and fractions and speed and distance and time, and how can they use that and apply that in a real world setting so they can get real world experience that's going to carry them forward as they hopefully look to possible STEM careers in their future. One of the best parts about our program really is how engaging it is for the kids. It gets students and reaches them at a level where they may not normally be interested in the material. You put a textbook in front of a student and they might be interested, but many are not. You get a robot in front of a student and that's intriguing. I want to learn more about that. And you can really reach your students who are struggling in both math and science. As they gain confidence, they start doing better in the subject areas, and then they start posting higher scores and learning more and asking deeper questions, and then they get more confidence, and it's a circular process. And it really comes back to just, what's that spark? What's that hook? What's that unique technology that's really going to get kids excited and get them on the right track? And that's really what I feel the robotics does for these students. It gets them excited, builds their confidence, and as a result, improves their learning dramatically. So it's just one more of many ways that we are successfully preparing all students for their futures in the Kent School District.